Okay guys, so here we are, Keystone Dam, right behind me, and the water levels are extremely low, right there as you can see behind me. So I plan on doing two things here today. It's 12:30 on a Friday, and the two things I plan on doing, try to catch a fish, and get down there and see if I can't recover a couple $100 in fishing lure that I or somebody else has lost. I know that I've lost my fair share. So I'm on the south side of the dam. And usually, so it's a little more crowded. Not on a Friday. But come evening time, this place is going to be packed with fishermen. And the water's extremely clear. Spider webs. Oh. Attacked by the webs of spiders. So the water is extremely clear. I can see movement in the water down there. So the fish are here. Let's see if they're gonna bite. And in the last video, I had the Z-Man is tied on. I said nothing has changed. I haven't tied anything else on. Might get to that. Might not. Who knows? Depends on what's happening. And I'm always on the lookout for snakes. So, we'll see what happens there too. Alright, so, normally, everything behind me is covered in water. I'll just try to navigate this hair table. Let me flip you guys around. Okay, got the camera flipped around so I can focus on my path here a little easier. Yeah, this water is way down. When I was a kiddo learning how to fish, my uncle told me the way he likes to fish this river is wait for it to go down into pools and then go inspect the pools. Some of those fish that have gotten trapped in the pools need one of two things. They either need to be eaten or relocated out of the pool. Whoop. So, we'll see what happens if we find anything in a pool. Okay. Quick span. No snakes moving forward. South side of the river here is also used by four by four enthusiast. I absolutely love it when they come ripping through here while I'm trying to fish over here. But let's get you down to the water's edge so we can see what we're looking at. Water line. You can see on the rocks over there, usually comes up right here where I'm standing. So all that in front of me is usually underwater. Wow. This is where I caught my biggest striper. It's right in this location. Caught him on a slow retrieve on a white little fishy right up in through here. And if this is normal, this is a pretty deep pool right here when this sucker's full. Good 6-7 feet. And I have plenty of lures out there on those rocks. You see a fishing line right there. Alright, so here's the plan. Let's throw the Z-Man around. Z-Man chatterbait. And then on my Zebco 33, where are you? Let me find it. Here we go. The Zebco 33, you can't see it. Let me lay a rod down here. On a 33, I have simple jig that I tied. That is my creation. In fact, that is my dollar. That's my dollar store challenge. That's actual, well, it's kind of, this is bucktail. Got a little flash in it. Jig head. And that's actually pipe cleaner. Instead of good Chanel, I used pipe cleaner. So that's Honda 33. Now I'm gonna check out that pond, that little pool over there. Let's see what's happening over there. Yeah, checking out puddles. We do have some fish caught. I don't know what to do. There's no place to go. Can't tell quite what they are. They're too long and too short to be bluegills. What else we got in this pond? Nice little puddle off the river here. Nothing big that needs relocated. That's for sure. All right, moving on. So I went to the first puddle, way over there. Just made my way over here. There's a little tiny fish action happening there, but it's not really a puddle. It's open to the river. Here is the second puddle, and got a little action in here. I don't know if that's going to be picked up. There's a small fish in this clay on the water. But little fries, little guys. Only thing swimming in here. I didn't see it opened up over there into another puddle. Obviously cut off. And the whole time I'm walking to puddles, I'm checking for lures. I found one, it was too far gone. The chances of finding anything good out here are slim. We are way, way far away from, well, you can see the dam off in the distance. We're too far off from where the majority of the people fish. But me and a friend of mine, we're not afraid to come down here when the water is raging. And I know there's lures down here because I've lost them. I know that my friend has lost him as well. Well, aside from a little fish over there zigzagging, thankfully there's nothing big in here. It's sad when you have the whole river and you're reduced to a small little pool. Next pool, up ahead. Let's get up there and I'll check it out with you. Alrighty, well this pool's kind of divided into two pools. It still looks cut off. Looks like a deeper pool and there's a bait fish up here jumping around like crazy. Might have something chasing it. No, no, no. Get a little closer and see. Saw a snake. Just keep on moving this away. All right. There is something out there, folks. Oh, I see it. Oh, there's some nice ones out there. Oh, there's some big ones. There are some fish. Over here, something's chasing them. let's put that Z-man right towards that pipe off in the distance. Little bird poop on it. So that Z-man across there, crank it back and see what happens. Just give you a quick recap, because when I looked at my camera, it was on photo mode. We walked down the pathway and we started puddle hopping. The Arkansas River below the Keystone Dam, we get to this puddle, completely cut off by the river, and I could see something chasing some bait fish, a flurry of activity. So we decided to throw the Z-man buzz bait across this puddle and see if we can entice something into play in the game. So let's get that guy out there. Give it a nice little chatter. Bring it on home. I couldn't tell when I saw the fish. I couldn't tell quite what they were, but they are in here. So let's see if we can get one to take a little snack. Catfish, you're probably not gonna bite on this. Catfishy crawdads. That's what this is supposed to. There's a big one out there, guys. What in the world? I hooked a shad right where a shad is supposed to be. Oh, I wish I'd have brought my catfish pole. Alright, well there you go, guys. Snagged a shad on a Z-man. So let's get him off. I'm gonna save him for bait. Let's see if we can't catch one of these game fish. Or catfish, or I'll consider catfish a game fish. I can't believe I snagged. That is not the first time to do that, but not the one I was going for. All right, praise Jesus. Let's catch a good one. Can't believe that. Snagging a shad on a Z-man chatterbait. This drives so fast crazy with this. Let's go. Alright. One more cast. Right out in there. Let's bring it on back in and walk around the other side. Alright, let's bring it on in. Okay, Z-man. Let's grab our Zibco and see if we got a baggie in here. Yes. Terminal tackle. Some jigs I tied up, more jigs I tied up. Shad bag. Alright, bait. Get in there and stink up that backpack, because no doubt I'm going to forget about you. One of these days I'm going to come out and grab a feather off. Pull out my fly tying vise and do a from the nature jig, something like that. Do a from the nature jig and see if we can't catch something on it. That's like inches deep. There's nothing in there. Let's give this dollar store challenge a shot. Old bucktail. Alright, let's get this back out there. Something is out there chasing. Something is out there chasing a shad. I want in on that action. Slap this back on here. Let's go get our fishing pole. Let's see what's over here. The feller that didn't survive. Over here. Got another feller that didn't survive. They didn't quite make it to the water. So that's unfortunate. It'd been cool to get those fellers in some deeper water. But at the same time, can't be everywhere, right? Okay, so here we are at the next pool. See what we're looking at. Pretty shallow here on the west end. Well, you can see how you could easily lose a couple $100 of fishing tackle out here. As the river goes down, you get more into the sandy. More into the sandy floor, and less rocky. So you can throw a lot more chances and not worry so much about getting hung up. Let's just stand here and focus. Water's clear. And I'm not seeing any action in this pool. No shad, no movement, no swirls, no jumps. Not even a turtle. Even though I'd rather be in this pool. And that pole over there. Alright, let's move on up. I'm gonna be honest, I'm leaving this pole, walking up to this pole, just knowing that there's not gonna be anything in it, because I can see it's really shallow. And I look down and look at this. My golly. What do we have here? So we got a 3-ounce weight that has been bent back. We got a snap. A swivel and look at that. My, that looks like they just lost this rig. So into the backpack this whole system goes. So made it to the other pool, and I know that there's nothing in there because you can tell where the water line was when the only fish that were in there were met with their demise. So that's what happens. Let's get over to the next pool, which is going to be on the other side of those trees. Is that a rod and reel? Man, I want to go over there. Now I want to go over there. I'll circle around. Alright. Alrighty guys, just made it through the trees. The path of least resistance. Got bit by something on the way through too. Usually where the water rushes over. I got one pool here. Another pool there, there, and here. And then scattered pools over there. I got a birds scoping out that pool. No doubt we got bait fish in it. No other reason for them to be there other than to eat lunch. And it is 1:14 until this point here, and it creates a little rapid, a little waterfall action. And then usually you're on the bank up there fishing out. And a buddy of mine will bring his waders out here, because you can see it's obviously not too deep. There are some deep spots. And he pulls in stripers in this area. Look at that. We were only here to save him. Oh. Water goes down, you gotta get to some deep water fish. So just puddle jumping down here at the Arkansas River, down below Keystone Dam. I'm not gonna keep you guys along too much on the bouncy trek to the next ponds. So what I'm gonna do, because there's too many of them, to stop and show you each one. I'll show you if I find something interesting. Then we'll go fishing. Okay guys, folks. I've made it to the end of the puddles. So I'm standing on this very large pond there. You know, this is the catfish hangout right here. Anyway, I'm gonna turn back around so you can see. Behind me, that is the Keystone Dam. So we walked quite a bit. It's now 1:30. So I think I spent about an hour down here just puddle jumping. Jumping all of these puddles back behind me. No real sign of life except for one, and couldn't get anything to bite on it, on the chatter bait, that is, anyway. So now I've reached the Arkansas River, and pretty much my plan is I'm gonna throw a V pattern in the water, starting up here, and just working my way to the other side of the V. Then I'm going to throw back the other way. So you're basically fishing in a V pattern, progressively getting further and further out as you go. So if you go out way far and there just happens to be one fish out there, you don't want to drag it through, you know, 10 fish that are close to you. You want to fish close and then out. So I'm going to fish that and then work my way back up the main channel and go over and see if I can't find more fishing tackle. Got a carp. Just swimming back and forth right here, just zigzagging, taking it easy. Life is good. Okay, so that sound you just heard is the dam's alarm that they're about to open the dam up, which means all this dry ground I am walking on is no longer gonna be dry. So old Rich making a beeline to the sandy beaches. get the heck off of this riverbed and onto some dry land. Okay, yeah, it's deer tracks. Okay. Whew. So, I'm a little out of breath, and here's the reason why. I was way, way out there, and the dam is, every gate's closed when I got here. Whew. So what happens before they open the gates, they sound that alarm. That was the fourth alarm. Oh, good Lord, I'm out of shape. So that was the fourth alarm. And I made it all the way over here. By the fourth alarm, as the fourth alarm rang, now the fifth alarm. So we are definitely in the clear. And if the water rages enough, you bet your bottom dollar I'll be up that hill. So, only disappointment I have is, I thought I saw a fishing pole out there, rod reel combo, whole 9 yards. Somebody probably lost out of a boat. I wanted to check it out. Never got around to it. And of course, the alarm went off. And since this one is staying on, this one's staying on, and if I can angle you, I don't know if you're going to see the dam there or not, but you can see where the water is starting to trickle through some of those slots. Oh, I'm going to take it easy, rest a little bit. So anyway, that's still not going to stop me from getting my fishing on. I know where the safe areas are, where the water flows, where it doesn't. And today, I was able to educate myself on where some of the deeper holes were. Another benefit to ponds, to puddle jumping. Anyway, let me go back up here where I was gonna fish. And I can already see the white cap at the bottom of the dam. But now we're safe and sound, let me get up there where I was going to fish anyway and see what happens. I've never fished this area when they just opened the dam, so I have no clue what that does to the fish. But like I say, let me get up there and figure it out. Okay, so this is going to conclude the below the dam portion. And as you can see, pretty much all the spots I was out there walking on, they're covered. They're covered. Now, if you look at the dam, they only have 8 gates open, and they are at a slow trickle, a very slow trickle. Now, that very slow trickle quickly covered up all the area I was walking on. Every inch of rock that I stood on today is now covered with water. And if you can see way down there in the distance, just below the trees where the river starts to bend, it is white cap. So what seems to be very, very little water at the dam can make a huge difference in the river levels. So when you hear those alarms go off, it's no joke, guys. Get out the way. Get ready, because it's going to move. It's going to move quick. And they gave, I didn't count them all, I think 5-6 warnings. Last warning was a big long one.
Hey guys, so if you made it this far, we're at the end of the video, and we're at the point where data becomes corrupted, and I have to say, comment, like, subscribe, and have a great day.